Conscious Web TV, and a very warm welcome to you on the show once again. Today we'll be talking about fitness, dealing with office depression, and how exercises can
get rid of office depression.
Yes, can get rid of office
stress.
Stress. You know, I know many of you don't know about this, but today I'm here with a fitness trainee. Or a trainer,
a fitness trainer,
a vocalist, and also a radio presenter, and his name goes by Samad. Hello.
I'm good.
See, we are ready to do some.
Ready?
Yes. Yoga.
Yoga moves and crunches, mountain climbing, and crunches on the floor.
Samad has a lot of clients he coaches every day, and of course, I had to beg him for just 1 hour for this show, and thank God he's here with me.
I'm good. I'm glad being here.
Yes, we are
glad
good
to be part of the Web TV programs and all that. So we're going to take you on the ride and things you can do in the office if you're getting depressed. If you know those assholes and bosses of the office
like
getting to you and all that.
I resume work 7:50 and I go home by
six.
And I stay on that chair. Okay, we have a break of 1 hour, and that is the only time I get to move around. Except maybe I just want to do that.
That's
on
for
my
lunch.
Own. Is that healthy enough?
No, not really. You need to find time out to really work out. At least if you're working out for like 3 hours every week, that'd be good enough for you. Let's say you can split it into like 20 minutes, 30 minutes every day, or a day on, a day off. Like you're working out on Monday, you might not work out on Tuesday, you work out on Wednesday. You must definitely find your rhythm with this.
Really?
It doesn't matter, probably you leave home early and you're in the office. You can find a way of working out for like 15, 10 minutes in the office.
But what if I don't have a gym around my office vicinity? How do you think I can do that? Working out in the office without disturbing my colleagues?
No, you can actually, some of your colleagues can even join you as well. You know, try to create a kind of exercise.
Okay. So how can we do it?
That's what we're here for.
Okay.
To do.
All right.
So that probably people who cannot make time out. Some of my clients, they said they can't come for my morning class. They can't even make it on Saturday because they have to sleep. They have to drive down to Victoria Island, you know, far away. So that's why we're here, just to make sure. All you need to do is just make sure you have your mat.
Okay. Mats. Do offices, some offices, do they accept mats?
It depends on the space in the office.
Okay.
If you have a space, it'll be good for you.
All right. There's something I've always wanted to find out.
Okay.
Ever since the advent of Slim Tea and all, what do you think about exercise? A lot of people find exercise as hard work.
Hard work.
And a lot of people, you know, depend on Slim Tea, diet, fruits, and all. Do you think it's really making you...
Trust me. All what they're trying to create is to tell you that even while you intend to work out,
okay,
if you're working out 1,000 calories, and you're hitting back like 2,000 calories. All those teas, all those herbal stuffs, just to let you know that it's not about your workout, it's not about the diet. It's more of the diet, like 80% diet, then 10% your workout, and 10% are you able to have a rest, you know, and all that. So coming back to your question, you know, that doesn't mean if you're taking all those herbal tea and the rest of them, that you shouldn't work out. Work out has a little long way. It's not about you burning your fat. It's not about... It has to do with a whole lot. People are majorly concerned about the physiological aspect. Because they want to trim down, they want to have these six packs, they want to have, the ladies want to have a very slim tummy and all that. Exercise is beyond all that.
Line.
The tea is going to help, but you need to work out. No pain, no gain, that's what.
What of workers who go out as early as 4:30 in the morning and come back like 11, talking about the bankers? How do you think they can work out? And maybe during the working hours, there's no time for this proposed exercise.
Yes,
how do you think they can balance work?
For me, when they come to me like that, most times, and I tell them, you need to just still find out time. Because if you don't do that, if you don't leave the work will leave you someday.
Okay.
So what you do is you find a way to work out on Saturday.
Okay.
You have to wake up early. And there are some particular exercises you need to do when you wake up. So if you're giving them like 5-7 minutes, you're still good.
Is this business lucrative? Fitness training.
Very, very. I can tell you that.
So a client, for how much does a client go for?
It depends on how many times in a week. Working out, how many hours we're working out.
Okay, if I want
depends
to work,
on the location.
If I want to work out 2 hours every day, or maybe one
2 hour. 2 hours every day. Babe, you want to make it to the Olympics?
Maybe you can say so.
Yeah.
Because I know some people are work out crazy.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
But okay, if
you
I want to work out
30
minutes every day for a week, straight on, how much are you getting?
That's 7 days.
7 days straight on Monday to Sunday.
Majorly, we could charge for like 2,000 per session.
2,000 per session. 2,000 times 7, that's you're going for 14,000. Ooh. Just for one client.
Yes.
So, and I see you with almost 50 clients.
No, that doesn't, that's a group thing.
Okay.
We're talking about person, one-on-one.
One-on-one. Because after,
you have to pay more.
When I saw you coaching the group and after the coach,
okay,
someone said, you said something like, I'm going home for the personal training. So those people, do they still do personal training after the group stuff in the morning?
No, really, no.
Okay.
The personal training is for those who, I train people by 9 o'clock, 9 p.m. I mean.
Okay.
And I do train people like 4:30, 5:30 before they leave for the office.
All right.
So such people, is you know, they pay for my inconvenience, you know. By the time my body is shutting down like 8 o'clock, I still have to go somewhere to train them. So
train them. So the training involves not just gym, swimming, and
yes. Race. I'm a swim instructor as well.
Oh, you're a swim instructor. So yeah. How often do you do that?
Almost every day if I have a client. I work on their time and I work on my own time.
Okay.
When they're available, I should be available. Okay. So first of all, for you, probably in the office, you have some little space like this.
Okay.
What you need to do is, before you go into your crunches and all that, just like you want to drive your car, you have to check maybe all those things, like your tires and all that, so you need to check into your joint.
So
you start this way, you start cut stretches. We're going to do like three stretches program. You hold, and your head is down, your feet down, then you fold your leg.
Do anything, girl, make you feel alright. Bump on drink, I jump on. Do you wanna feel alright? Go cold in my cup, I just wanna feel alright. Last day, birthday, sex make you feel alright. I'm a boy connect, I'ma get come collect. If your head connect, I mean you want collect.
Stand up, stretch. You don't go too
fast.
You need to come up.
Okay.
Stretch. You need to get your shoes. Go down. Okay.
I'll do make you feel alright. Bump on drink, I jump on. Do you wanna feel alright? Don't go in my cup, I just wanna feel alright. Birthday, birthday, things make you feel alright. I'm a boy connect, I'ma get come collect. If your head correct, I mean you want collect.
She's not till done, do you wanna feel alright?